On BBC Radio Gloucestershire. Now, magicians and illusionists Penn and Teller have been amazing audiences across the world for years now. But they've been amazed themselves recently, thanks to 17-year-old twin girls from Gloucester, Poppy and Sasha Van Hagen. They went to Las Vegas, the girls, to showcase their speed telepathic magic in front of Penn and Teller on their show Fool Us. And the girls did. They fooled them. They couldn't work out how they'd done it, so they returned to Gloucester with a trophy and an invite to go back to Vegas with the mighty Penn and Teller at a show. The girls came into the studio with their trophy last night, and I asked Poppy to tell me a bit about their story's performance.
Our performing history, we've always been excited to perform and present ourselves, whether it be music, whether it be through just presenting. You know, we used to do verse speaking when we were quite young as well. Okay. So we've performed in front of a few live audiences, specifically for music, but nothing as big as this.
So how much magic have you done live before, Sasha?
With regards to live magic, I think this experience, taking on the Penn and Teller Fool Us stage, was our first big gig, essentially. But you know, with regards to performing in general, we started our magic journey with opening a box of Marvin's Magic set, you know, at Christmas time. And you know, reflecting on it now, we kind of feel like that's a full circle experience, because only recently we actually interviewed the man himself, Mr. Marvin Berglas, the CEO. Yeah, and we discussed things such as, you know, young entrepreneurship, innovation, you know, digitizing magic and the opportunities there.
And we've actually been invited back to the Magic Circle, where we'll be performing this Sunday, which is so exciting.
So you are members of the Magic Circle at the moment?
We're not members.
You're not.
But you know what? That would be awesome. That would be so cool.
You've got to get in, haven't you, now?
I know.
If you fill Penn and Teller.
Well, exactly, yes, yeah.
Automatic invite.
Let's see. I'll do some asking then.
Yeah, you've got it. You've got to ask the question. So this act that you took over to the States, first of all, how hard is it to get your act in front of Penn and Teller? What did you have to go through, Poppy?
So it took a lot of just commitment, dedication, you know, coming up with the Olympic theme and creating the scripts, the magic behind it. And for us, we were quite lucky where we were invited to perform on the Penn and Teller show. So we worked closely with the Fool Us team and just brought our magic to the stage. So we were quite fortunate there.
So how did they become aware of you then, Sasha?
So we have been doing, as we said, quite a bit of performing behind the scenes, and it wasn't always magic orientated. As we said, we love music, we love drama and things like that. So I think they really took to our energy as two characters, and we hope to be, you know, the female versions of the classic Anton Deck. That would be, you know, the overall dream there. And I think that's what they saw in us, and we love magic. We found a really cool way to show energy and magic and just bring something new, really.
So Anton Deck was Stephen Mulhern's magic, basically.
I know,
mixing
exactly.
Two together
exactly.
And you get Poppy and Sasha. So tell us a bit about your routine then. What did you perform for them?
So we came up with this really awesome concept, the Telepathic Olympics. And we've always had a passion with sports, and we thought, you know what, let's just encompass something so awesome. Just mash it all together. You know, the Poppy and Sasha just fused, and we created the Telepathic Olympics. We started off with a little warm-up, got the audience going a bit crazy, and then we went on to do a couple of other things. We focused really on fast telepathic transmission between each other. Things with medals, things with cards. I think you really got to watch it. It's hard to contain it in just a couple of seconds, but yeah.
But basically, it's you passing messages to each other.
As fast as we can. Yeah.
Yeah.
And how close did Penn and Teller get to working out what had happened?
Ooh, that's the question.
So, I believe that Penn was, I think that he was a little stumped by it. So, he asked us outright, what did, in other words, you know, was it a force, was it coded, was it this, and because usually sometimes they try and code it in a magical way magician to see if you know, to see if they're on the same wavelength there.
They try and disguise it, you see.
But he just asked outright, so
and he was wrong.
It was wrong. And do you know what, actually, the online interaction, we've seen a couple of things on things like Reddit, YouTube, and everyone is just like coming up with these really epic ideas. And we were like, do you know what? We should have done it that way.
But you didn't.
And no, we didn't.
Did you tell them afterwards?
No.
So they still
don't
know.
Secrets kept between us two, I'm afraid.
It's a twin thing.
It's a twin thing. They still don't know. What have your friends made of this? Going over there to America, to Vegas, and fooling Penn and Teller?
Yeah, actually, I'll let you into a little secret. We jetted off to America just 1 week before our first A-level exam.
Wow.
Yeah, crazy. So we did the whole thing. Our friends were like, where have they gone? And only recently, because this was filmed ages ago,
yeah.
And we've been able to talk about it now, and everyone's like, oh, so that's where you went. And I was like, you know what? The past 5 months have been so hard not to tell you guys. But yeah, they love it, absolutely love it.
Were you telepathically passing answers to each other across the A-levels table?
Oh, no. I wish. No.
They're starting to think that now, aren't they? Hang on a minute. that's what they do. But they've now been able to see it on YouTube and check out the way that you went over there. They must be pretty impressed.
Yeah, we've had some really positive feedback, not just from our friends, but wider communities as well. You know, we've actually had Penn and Teller give us a thumbs up on Instagram. We've had, you know, our content seen by Stephen Bartlett, Jonathan Ross,
Ian Wright, and even Andy Peters.
I think Ben Shepherd as well, and also Piers Morgan. So It has got quite a bit of visibility and, lots of positivity around it, so...
And in fooling them, you now have to go back to Vegas, yeah?
Absolutely.
What a shame, eh?
Oh, yeah. No, we're absolutely delighted to be given the opportunity just to tackle that stage again. And, you know, between each other, we just always reminisce that moment and looking forward to doing it again, really.
So when you go back, is that just one night only you go out and then perform, or do you run a series of shows? Do you know what's happening yet, Poppy? What are you expecting?
So we are not sure just yet. We do know it's a stage show. It's a Penn and Teller stage show in their fabulous theatre. I believe that we'll be coming back as winners, or foolers in this case, and presenting our own unique act again. But we're still yet to decide what we're going to bring to the stage, but it's all to come in due course.
I'm sure it's going to be something very Van Hagen. So
so are you going to change this then? You're not going to repeat what you did originally. You're going to do something new?
No, I think something about both Poppy and I is we love to bring something fresh to the stage each time. Just give the audience something new to see.
But will it be telepathic?
Absolutely.
Yeah. So this is going to be your
trademark,
you're going to stick with the telepathic twins.
It is, yeah.
Brilliant. And you've got your trophy with you. Let's have a look at your trophy.
It's so sparkly.
It is.
You know, it just brings back great memories.
I fool Penn and Teller with the fool-less star above it as well. Where are you keeping that in the moment?
Oh, so actually, you know, Alison Hannigan said, I wonder how you two are going to split this trophy. We worked it out. It's okay.
Where does it sit? On the landing? So you can both look at it?
It's actually currently in my room. We're taking it in turns.
You take it in
turns? Yeah, I take it in
turns. All right, just to admire it every morning.
Yeah.
And obviously it means a lot because so many magicians from all over the world try to fool Penn and Teller. That's you know, that's the way it's set up, and most of them fail, don't they?
Yeah, I think we're very honoured to have been given the opportunity to showcase our craft, and, you know, it's absolutely incredible that we managed to get the result we did. And no better stage than to tackle the American stage, I suppose.
Absolutely.
Yeah, exactly, and in front of Penn and Teller.
Absolutely. Well, you've kind of nailed Vegas. What about Gloucestershire? Are we going to be able to see you doing your stuff on a stage near Gloucestershire soon or
100%. No, we would love to show our community exactly what we've got. But the great thing is about social media, it is online. So even if we take it abroad and do things overseas, because we love to do big stuff, we want to supersize our content. You can always check it out there.
Yeah, and you've done your A-levels.
Done our A-levels.
So what now? Are you professional magicians? What are you going to do? What's the next move?
So for us, we are degree apprentices at Bentley Motors. So we both do user experience design, and that's our current job, and we're absolutely loving it.
It's brilliant. Yeah.
Okay.
Both in the same department, working on the same stuff. It's just fantastic.
So you're working for Bentley at the moment, but they must know. If it takes off, you're taking off.
No, I think we absolutely love what we do at Bentley. And for us, we will be doing this juggling act, you know, presenting when we've got time, when the opportunities arise. But Bentley will always be there as well.
Yeah. And you've also got with you today a little bear, Gold Ted.
Little Gold Ted.
Tell me about Little Gold Ted.
So Little Gold Ted is an authentic British bear. You know, we made him, I think we started Little Gold Ted when we were about 15. We've published 2 children's books. We're the illustrators of Little Gold Ted. And
we've got a magic book in the pipeline. We've taken him to Vegas. He's seen Penn and Teller. So, yeah, he's a little bear of ours. So
So what's his story? Is he a magician? Is he a magic Ted, or have you just written him into your kind of stories with magic?
Yeah, so actually, well, Little Gold Ted's first ever story was him kind of getting lost in Gloucestershire. He bypasses the cathedral, eventually finds his way home, and it talks about friendship and things like that. But no, we are doing a magic book because we'd love to kind of encompass Little Gold Ted with us as Van Hagen taking on the stage and just showing kids that there is so much that you are able to do as a kid. You know, anything really is possible.
Yeah, well, you guys are proof of that, because the energy coming out of you is unbelievable. Obviously, you've had the confidence to go over to Vegas and take on Penn and Teller. You're illustrating your own books as well. You've just shown me one of your illustrations, which is pretty special as well. Are you both illustrators? You're both very arty. You share the same skills. You
I are, know.
As well as transmitting thoughts.
In twins, yeah. In every sense imaginable.
Yeah. Poppy, tell me, what is different about you? What are you good at that she's not and she's not and you are?
Well, in terms of Little Gold Ted, I am the designer behind the actual bear. Sasha's more of the landscapes and just, you know, reimagining the world around Little Gold Ted. So I guess our plan with him is to get him into animation, seen on screen by, you know, millions of children around the world, and just to, you know,
make him a bit more tangible, really.
Yeah, well, kids love magic, don't they? I can see the magic thing taking off, you know, definitely.
Yeah, kids absolutely love magic. I think we're testament to that, so.
Yeah, you are.
We're really excited to explore just how big the magic scene is in the UK and start to take our magic further around the UK. You know, let's look at going to London and things like that.
Yeah, get out there and doing a few gigs.
You fancy absolutely.
Doing a few gigs? Yeah. So are we going to see you on British TV? I mean, what?
I can't say too much there.
Okay, so we might do then.
We might do, yes.
We might see you on British
Fingers
TV.
Fingers crossed, yeah.
Okay, let's move on from there. When do you fly to Vegas? When's the big moment?
I think that's to be decided, because unfortunately we've heard recently that Teller had a heart bypass, heart bypass. So that's been kind of put on the back burner for a bit. So we'll hear about the dates in due course, and, you know, fingers crossed he gets better. And we'll be looking forward to that.
Brilliant. And your mum's with you today. They must be pretty proud, all your family as well.
Absolutely, yeah. I think it's been brilliant taking mum on the journey as well.
How hard has it been for her to keep it quiet? Because you had to keep it quiet.
Oh, no.
But proud mum.
Yeah, she's just like us. I mean, she's our triplet, really.
Yeah, the Van Hagen triplets. Yeah, no, it's been fabulous taking, you know, mum along to Vegas as well. And we've all managed to keep it under wraps and not say anything. So, yeah. You know, it's just been really good.
But now the word's out there. It's been broadcast in America. And everyone can see it. It's on the web.
Everyone can see it, yeah. I mean, if those of you that are interested to see it, it is on YouTube. Something under the lines of 17-year-old twins, full Penn and Teller, something like that. But yeah, give Van Hagen a search, the Van Hagen twins a search, and you'll definitely see it there.
I've got a feeling we might be hearing a bit more about the Van Hagen twins in the future as well.
Yeah.
Thank you ever so much for coming in to have a chat to us, and good luck with Vegas and whatever else comes up. Thank you.
Oh, thank you so much. Chat soon.
Thank you.
The Van Hagen twins from Gloucester, they amazed, they fooled Penn and Teller, and waiting for their invite to go back to Vegas then when everybody's fit and well, and to go and perform on the strip with Penn and Teller. What a great kind of prize that is for them as well. And if they're not doing that, they're doing magic books and designing cars, all sorts of things. Whew. I've only had the energy, eh? It's BBC Radio Gloucester, 7 minutes to 4.